Hey, good morning, Birchwood. How are you guys doing? I was thinking of you guys on a car ride today. So we drove on Friday. We drove from Two Rivers to where we're living now, up through Birchwood, right? And then we went up to Duluth, and we went and watched Eric's game, and then we were driving back through. Okay? And then I was thinking of this song as we were driving home. Hello, Birchwood. Hello, Birchwood. Hello, Birchwood. How are you today? Hello, Birchwood. Hello, Birchwood. Hello, Birchwood. You can't get rid of me. Right? Here I am. So I'm going to hang out with you guys for as long as we figure out that I should be hanging out with you. And I'll just have a couple questions for you. The first thing I have to find out is who's going to be watching you. Like, are the teachers going to be watching you? Or is an aide going to be watching you, or a para? Or is Alessandra watching all the music classes? Like, how are we going to take care of this? And then the second thing we have to find out is, where do your teachers want you? Do you want to do music in your class? Do you want to do music down in the music room? So let's talk over Google Stream and try to figure that out. And this Friday, Eric has another game up in Duluth. So I'm going to stop by Birchwood on Friday and talk to the teachers. Yay! And get to see people and go to class and ask them what they want. How does that sound? Pretty good? All right, so all the stuff that we need, I'm going to put on Google Stream. I'll put on the video links, and when we have challenges, we'll put challenges up on Google Stream. Or if I have a question for you, we can put that up on Google Stream. And the older kids have their own Google accounts. The younger ones don't, so they might have to ask teachers to post for them. Okay. But here's our first question for you. Your first question I want you to put on Google Stream. And that is, so we're driving back from Duluth through Birchwood, then through Rice Lake and Eau Claire, and then over to Wausau and Green Bay and then Two Rivers. And the question came up, guess what came up when I'm listening to the radio? As I'm listening to the radio, guess what I heard? I heard Christmas songs. Can you believe it? I heard my first Christmas songs today. So then I started thinking, all right, Christmas songs are on the radio now. Now this weekend, Christmas decorations are going to start going up. Mm-hmm. So my question for you, and you can tell me on Google Stream, what do you want for Christmas? And anything you put up on Google Stream, I'll talk about it when we talk about your classes. Okay. So what do you want for Christmas? Let me know on Google Stream. How does that sound? Good? Okay. So what should we talk about now? Let's talk about where I am right now. Okay, so where am I? Well, let's start by figuring out where you are. So on this map right here, you're in Birchwood, Wisconsin. Okay. So on this map, there's Ed's. There's the school. There's Birch Lake, right? And we used to live up here on Bennett Lake, right there. That's where our house was, right there. So if we leave Birchwood and we go down through Makana, and then we go through Rice Lake, and then past Cameron, through Chautauqua, New Auburn, Bloomer, Chippewa Falls, and then we go across the state. So we go through Cadott and Boyd and Stanley Thorpe Withy, Abbotsford, Colby. This is where Mrs. Johnson's parents live, right in Colby. Then we go through Edgar and Wausau. Then we go through Wittenberg and Shawano. And then we go over here to Green Bay. And then through Green Bay, we go down through Denmark and Mishicot. And there's Two Rivers. Okay? So Two Rivers, that's where I'm living right now. This is right here. And I'm here. And you are here. And this is Wisconsin. That's the outline of Wisconsin right there. So here's my schedule. Okay. I coached football in Two Rivers. And then I teach elementary music in Manitowoc. And then one day a week, I teach middle school band in Sheboygan, right here. And then I'm with you in Birchwood over here. So I said before, I'm going to be on Friday. So I'm going to stop in and see everyone. And the two things I want to know is who is watching you and where do you want to be? Do you want to be in the music room or do you want to be in your classrooms? And we'll figure that out together and try to make this work for everyone. How does that sound? So I teach you here in Birchwood and I teach in Two Rivers right there. And I teach in Manitowoc and I teach in Sheboygan, which is kind of a neat job. See if your teacher likes this, because I'm doing so many different jobs. No one ever knows where I'm at, right? So I'm like a ghost. I'm like going in and out of places. I'm fitting through the cracks. I'm operating in the ether. That might sound good to your teachers. It sounds good to me. I love it. And I love seeing you guys again. Now, speaking of seeing you guys again, I went on your site, and this is what I found. I found your Halloween pictures. So I was so excited to see these. And it reminded me of all the Birchwood kids. And how much fun Halloween was. With the trick-or-treat around town. Cute costumes and scary ones. Steve. Wow. Birthday and Halloween. Double threat. Hey, Alessandra. Hello. Hey, pal. Yes. Jasmine. And we're back to the beginning. So what I wanted to show you was the costume that I wore and then what I did for Trunk or Treat, just because I love Halloween. It looks like you guys love it too. So this year, Sophie and I made this costume. So we took some football pads, right? And we bought a mask online. And then we took some shoulder pads, and then we took some shoulder thigh pads, and then some hockey knee pads that we got from Goodwill, and a rope we got from Goodwill. And then we had these wristbands and old gloves. And then on the wristbands, we put buttons from an adding machine calculator, and we added those on, and then we drew some things on, like the clan symbol for the Mandalorian and the signet for the Mandalorian. We did that. Isn't that pretty cool? And then at my Sheboygan school, we had trunk or treat. So we did this. in the back of my truck, I put Grogu with the Death Star, and then some Stormtrooper helmets, and some jack-o'-lanterns, and then the Mandalorian. Cool. And then we made some jack-o'-lanterns that said, "This is the way." And another one that was of the Mandalorian. And then another one of Grogu. And then another one of the clan emblem of the Mandalorians. Isn't that cool? But your question today is, what do you want for Christmas? I know it's early, but I saw the decorations start going up, and I heard the songs on the radio. So if you go on Google Stream, you just let me know what you want for Christmas, and then on the next video, I'll go through and then talk about it. Sound good? Okay. All right, I'll smell you later. And actually, I'll see you on Friday. Okay. Graders, let's say hello to 7 people this morning on Tuesday. Is it morning? Let me check my schedule here. Third grade, Tuesday. Oh, it's actually afternoon. Good afternoon, third grade. Good afternoon on this Tuesday. Katie. Now, I'm thinking Katie's probably not in with you guys right now, would be my guess, right? If she is, hello, Katie. And if she's not, make sure you say hello to Katie today. Okay. She would love it. There's Parker. Good morning, Parker. Or good afternoon, Parker. Hope you're having a good Tuesday, Parker. And Parker, what do you want for Christmas? Like I said, I know it's early, right? But, hello, Caspin. Happy Tuesday afternoon. Caspin, what do you want for Christmas? Like I said, I know it's early, but on the drive from Duluth, Christmas songs on the radio. Right, Bianca? Happy Tuesday. What do you want for Christmas? Christmas songs on the radio, people putting up Christmas decorations along the route. Good morning, Kate. What do you want for Christmas? Let us know on Google Stream. I knew it. Ashlyn, hello. Ashlyn, hope you have a good Tuesday. And I'll show you how to mark on Google Stream what you want to put down for what you want for Christmas. So all you have to do is go to your page, third grade, not classwork, not people, just stream right there. And then just type in here. So I'm going to type. Mr. Johnson wants a puppy for Christmas. Okay. Sadly, our dog Cooper died before we moved to Two Rivers. And, you know, it's not easy to get another pet. But at some point, you think to yourself, okay, we're ready. We can do this now. So if I post that, it says Mr. Johnson wants a puppy for Christmas. And now that's on our Google Stream. So everyone can see that and comment on it. So if I see what you want for Christmas on our Google Stream, on our next video, I can talk about it. Okay. Now I'm looking at this. Mr. Johnson wants a puppy for Christmas. Yes, I do. I don't know if Mrs. Johnson wants a puppy for Christmas, right? Now, when you're married kids, you have to start thinking about everyone besides yourself. So I'm going to delete it for now, but I will be revisiting this. All right, let's say good morning to one more person here. Or good afternoon. Good Tuesday afternoon. Gunner, happy Tuesday afternoon. What do you want for Christmas? Let us know on Google Stream. All right. The next thing we're going to do is I didn't know if you want to go and do singing guy or I don't know if you want to do sight read. Okay. So I'm going to start with sight read. And if you like sight reading, we'll keep doing it. If not, we can always go back to singing guy or we can do both. It's up to you. But here's your first sight read. See what you think of this. Right now we are looking at our sight read for today. And we are starting, we're just going to read it first. And the first one we're going to start with is we're saying that this is in the key of C. And we'll talk more about this later, but how do you know if something's in a key of C? Well, the first thing we do is we look at this time signature, and there's the treble clef, and we said it's also known as the G clef because it circles the G right there. Okay, so we know that. And then what we do is we look in the treble the signature, and if we don't see any sharps and flats, it's either in the key of C major or A minor. And right now we're just in major keys, so that we know that this is in the key of C major. Okay, and that's not really important now. We'll come back to that later. But we're starting on the C note. Okay, so it goes C D E C D E C D E D C C E D C E D C E D C D C. But what we're doing is we're starting to talk about solfege. So we're going to call our first note do. Okay. So do you see any more do's? Do, re, mi. Yep. That's a do. Do, re, mi. Yep. Do, re, mi, re. Do. Do. Mi, re, there it is again, do. Mi, re, do. Mi, re, do. Re, do. Cool, so we found all the do's. And do is this. It goes do, re, mi. Okay, so we've got do. Now let's take a look at the next one. What do we have? We have re. So this is do. Yep. Re. Do, re, mi. Do, re. Yep. Do, re, mi. Do. Re, mi. Re. Do. Do. Mi. Re. Do. Mi. Re, do, mi, re, do, so the last thing we have is mi. So it's going to go do, re, mi, do, re, mi. Okay? So let's find all the mi's, and that's the last one. So it goes do, re, you got it, mi, do, re, mi, do, re, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, re, do. Cool. Now, we don't even know what this sounds like, but I'm kind of guessing. I'm guessing it's going to go like this, and I'm going to use my hand signs too. I'll slide these over, and I think it's going to go do, re, mi, do, re, mi, do, re, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, re, do. That's what I'm guessing. So let's go over to here and find out. All right, so here's our song right there. And let's see if it'll let us zoom it in. Yeah, we can zoom it in a little bit there. All right. So we think we know what it sounds like. So let me just give you the first tone.
starts here. That's what we're thinking. All right. So let's just listen to our part. You sing along with me. Okay, we're going to sing do, re, mi, do, re, mi, do, re, mi, re, do, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, re, do. Here we go. First note. Here we go. Do, re, mi, do, re, mi, do, re, mi, re, do, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do, re, do.
Okay. So now the next step is we have your part playing, sing along with me, and we're going to add the background. All right, and they're going to try to see if you can keep this same melody that we just sang, even if there's a different background. So here we go. First note.
Do, it starts in do, here we go.
Next part of this, I'm going to move this over a little bit, see if that's distracting to you or not. The next part of this is we want to take your part off completely. So it's only the accompaniment part. Here we go.
Oh, here we go.
Last one we have, accompaniments up. Your part is turned off. I'm not singing with you. Sing this one through. See if you can read and follow. Here we go. Hey, proud of you. Good morning, good afternoon to some more friends on this Tuesday, November 9th. And I know Zofia. What a cool name. Hey, what do you want for Christmas, Zofia? Let us know on Google Stream. If I pronounce any names wrong, spell them wrong, let me know. It's important, right, that people spell your name correctly. And morning, Avery. And pronounce your name correctly. Just a sign of respect. Avery, what would you like for Christmas? And Quinn. Hello, Quinn. Happy Tuesday. I'm glad we're here together, Quinn. What would you like for Christmas? And here's Harper. Harper, happy Tuesday. Glad we're together. Let us know on Google Stream, Harper, what you want for Christmas. And there's Adeline Katie. And we said hello to Katie earlier. Let's do two more friends right now. And remember, go say hi to Katie today if she's not with you. Hey, Wyatt. I was thinking about you, Wyatt, how much you liked drums. I hope you're having a good day. And let me know on Google Stream, Wyatt, what you want for Christmas, our last friend for right now. There's Adeline. Morning, Adeline. Have a good Tuesday. Let me know on Google Stream what you want for Christmas. And right now, you're going to look at ukuleles and guitars, comparisons, why they're alike, and contrasts, why they're different. And then there's a little like Chrome Lab app where you can vibrate strings. Remember, sound is just vibration. Where you can vibrate strings, you can see the vibrations, you can hear the sound, and then you have to determine, does a short string have a fast vibration or a slow vibration? And does a low note have a fast vibration or a slow vibration? All right? I bet you'll be able to figure that out. So just play with that and have fun.
Okay. So do you know what this is? This is a ukulele. Kind of looks like a guitar, doesn't it? A little bit different. We'll talk about why it's different, but let's talk about sound first. And sound works by vibrations. So say vibration. Vibration. So that's just something moving, right? When something vibrates, it moves. Right, so can you see that? When I hit that, you can see that string shaking. It's vibrating. Okay. And what happens is the faster something vibrates, the higher the sound. And then the slower something vibrates, the lower the sound. All right? So I have a string right here. That's vibrating. You might be able to see that. But if I put my finger here, I shorten the string so it vibrates faster. So the shorter it is, the faster the vibrations, and the higher the sound. Okay? So now when we learn how to play like a ukulele or we learn how to play a guitar or something that vibrates, really all we're doing is we are just kind of getting patterns of vibrations down. So I made a pattern here. If I put my finger here, that makes a C chord. So it sounds like this. And if I put my finger on the yellow one, I make an A minor chord. It sounds like this. And if I put my fingers on the pink notes, it makes F chord. And then in music theory, we always kind of go back to where we started from. So I go back to that C. So I can have a song. That's the ukulele. Guitar, same thing, vibrations. So here's the guitar. Now we notice that the guitar is bigger, right? So do you think that first string is going to be lower or higher than this one? It's longer, So it vibrates slower. So I'm thinking lower. It is lower. That's a lower sound. What else is different between the ukulele and the guitar? So like, yeah, the ukulele is shorter, right? How many strings on a ukulele? 1, 2, 3, 4. We can count the tuning pegs and say 1, 2, 3, 4. We can count the strings and say 1, 2, 3, 4. This one has 4. How many strings on a guitar? We could count the strings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or we could count the tuning pegs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, this has 6. This has 4. The strings are different too. This one has steel strings or copper alloy, but like a metal string, so that sounds different. And this one has plastic or nylon strings, so that's different too. But the interesting thing is, even though this one is bigger and this has more strings and the strings are different, and this is smaller and has 4 strings and the strings are nylon, they still have the same shape chords. So if I make that green shape chord on a guitar, it sounds like this. And if I make that yellow shape chord, like on the ukulele, it sounds like this. And if I make that pink shape chord on the ukulele, we have this. And then we go back to the green. Isn't that cute? So the next thing I have for you is a little game to play. And this game is about just playing with vibrations. Sound good? All right. See you later, pal.
Hey, let's say good morning to the rest of our friends this morning. Remember, if I spell anything wrong, if I pronounce it wrong, correct me. Dexter, good morning. I think I got that one right. Dexter, have a great Tuesday, and let me know on Google Stream what you would like for Christmas. Millie, Maleficent, hello. Glad to see you. Hope you're doing well. Have a good Tuesday, and let me know on Google Stream, Millie, what you want for Christmas. Hello, Dixie. Dixie, Dixie, what do you want for Christmas? Let me know right on Google Stream. Who do we have? Ella. Hey, Ella. Have a great Tuesday and let me know, Ella, what you want for or what you want for Christmas. Kay Din. Who are you going with? I'm going with Kay. What do we got, Kaden? Yes. Kaden, have a great Tuesday. Hope you're having a great week, and let us know on Google Stream what you want for Christmas. The next thing we have, and gosh, I'm running long, and I'm sorry about that. But Mrs. Jerry will remember this from the Breakfast Club. The world is an imperfect place, right? Screws fall out all the time. Are we going to make mistakes doing what we're doing right now? Yes, we're going to make a whole bunch of them. But we'll eventually kind of get into to our right lane. All right. So what was I going to say? Oh, the next thing that you have right now is, let me check. Oh, we're going to talk. Yeah. We're talking about that app. The app with the vibrations. Okay. And that's on Chrome Lab. And I put that app up on your Google Stream. Okay, so have fun. Smell you later.
And we said, like, the shorter a string gets, the faster it vibrates. So the higher the sound. So in this game, and I'm going to include this link on our stream for today, all we have to do is look here. And you can see the first one. It's that long. Can you hear that? And then when you go to this one, those are split in half. So these should be higher. It is higher. And this one is the same length as this one. So they should have the same sound. They do sound the same, don't they? Now this one is longer than this one, so this one should be lower. Yeah. And this one's even longer than that one, so it should be lower. And this one is longer than this one, so it's lower yet. And this one's longer than that one. And this is the lowest. Now, what happens to these strings? This one, to this one, to this one. Are they getting shorter or longer? Shorter. So do you think the vibrations will be faster or slower? Okay. And then do you think the sound is going to go higher or lower? All right, all stuff you got to figure out. Have fun and play with the strings on Music Lab. All right, I hope you had fun today, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, friends.